In this module, we'll demonstrate how to repair or replace a faulty brine valve. The symptoms include salty service water, excessive salt use, or overfilling brine tank. On this valve, we have a 1600 brine system. The brine valve is located on the side. We can test the brine valve by bringing in a screwdriver and checking to make sure it is not bound. If the valve is free and we still have water leaking to the brine tank, we then need to replace the valve. To remove the brine valve from a 2510 valve, we begin by loosening the nuts on the J-tube. First from the connection up by the injector, and second from the brine valve itself. Once loose, we pull the J-tube towards the rear in order to remove it. We then move to the connection on the brine valve. This would be the connection where the tube runs over to our brine tank. We can then loosen the nut from the front of the brine valve. As we loosen, we pull the brine valve to the rear of the unit. You may need to use a wrench in order to assist yourself with this. This is our plastic 1600 brine valve. This particular unit is rated for 0.5 gallon per minute. If you need to replace the valve, please make sure to match the brine line flow control. This other unit has the blue tag identifying it as a 0.25 gallon per minute brine line flow control. Your unit may also have a brass valve for this model. So long as the brine line flow controls match, you can swap between the two. Valves that use this backplate can use either the 1600 or 1700 system. The 1600 system is identifiable by measuring the height of the injector housing. This is approximately 1.5 inches for the 1600 system, or approximately 2.5 inches for the 1700 system. In order to reassemble the unit, you reverse the procedure, tightening the brine valve back to the back plate. Tighten all connections and make sure everything is airtight. Since these are flare connections, no plumber's tape should be used. You can then repressurize and test your progress. Thanks for watching.